I have sentenced scores of people to prison for murder, and when I assess the entire mountain of facts and evidence that exist in this case, I come to the conclusion that if I were to impose anything less than the maximum sentence in this case, I'd feel I had cheated the other people, because your crime is so enormous, so monstrous, so unspeakably cruel that it overcomes all other considerations. And Mr. Albee has correctly stated that there are plenty of positive factors in your background, and indeed the Supreme Court instructs us to consider a large number of factors in imposing sentence, but it is certainly the case that some crimes just are so enormous that they overcome any of the positive factors, and this ghastly crime is one of them. It's so saturated with malice, and I mean it's such long-standing malice, that the persistent tormenting, torturing of this woman during many years, and then when this affair started that you contemplated and planned and plotted this cruel method of execution for so long a period of time, the wickedness and cruelty of the manner of death that you elected in this case, just speak to the content of your character. There are a limited number of people who would do something like that, and those people are people that we need to remove from society to protect other people, to make an example of people who would do things like this, and ultimately to affirm the dignity of Julie Jensen's life. That's why you're here today. That's why we as a society collect to deal with transgressions like this. And I repeat that I would feel, when I compare the acts of others, the people who get into a barroom brawl and pull out a gun and shoot somebody and are sent to prison for life, against how you planned and executed this crime, that's not even a comparison. And as I say, I think I would have cheated them by sentencing them to prison for life if I don't impose the maximum sentence in your case. So unless there is some reason why sentence should not now be pronounced, I'll ask that you stand for sentence, please. Mr. Jensen, it is the sentence of the court that your custody be committed to the Department of Corrections for confinement in the Wisconsin State Prisons without possibility of parole for the remainder of your life. You may be seated. Your rights to appeal with respect to the disposition of your case and your attorney will review them with you. If you understand your rights, tell Mr. Albee he will have you sign a document acknowledging that. If you don't understand, tell him he'll bring you back in here for further instruction. There's a copy for you as well. Persons who are convicted of felony, as you have been, are ineligible to have firearms in their possession. That is a lifetime prohibition, and unless you have a permit from the Secretary of the Treasury, you may not have a firearm in your possession at any time for the duration of your life. It is a serious state and federal crime for you to do so. Mr. Albee will have you sign a document before you leave by which you acknowledge that you understand that it is unlawful for you to vote in any election held in this state until you, for the remainder of your life.